Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we are going to be talking about P0101 engine codes. If you have a P0101 engine code, it is going to read something like mass airflow circuit range slash performance or volume airflow circuit range slash performance. And while that isn't the easiest thing to comprehend, it does fortunately point us to the mass airflow sensor. So ultimately, a P0101 engine code is going to mean that you have a problem with the mass airflow sensor and the readings that that sensor is sending to your vehicle's computer. Fortunately, a P0101 engine code is not a very severe problem, and it's actually super easy to fix yourself. So go ahead and follow along with this video to save yourself some money by not having to take it to a shop to get this problem fixed. In this video, I'm going to go ahead and talk a little bit about what mass airflow sensors are, how they work, and what they do. From there, we'll talk about some of the signs and symptoms that are going to accompany a P0101 engine code, and then I will finish it off with a diagnostic list that you can go ahead and follow through to determine what the issue is and get that problem fixed so that you don't need to take your car to a repair shop. One other note, this is generic to any P0101 engine code, but these do tend to be a lot more common on GM vehicles, so on your Chevy and GMC trucks and cars, and that's because GM has very strict ranges for the mass airflow sensor. So with that being said, let's go ahead and talk just briefly about what a mass airflow sensor is. The mass airflow sensor sits on your intake piping, and its whole purpose is to read how much air is entering your engine. It takes this reading and sends it to the car's computer, which then uses it to calculate the proper air to fuel ratios. And because it's a crucial component for air to fuel ratios, if you have an issue with your mass airflow sensor, it typically leads to a number of noticeable performance-related issues. Ultimately, it's a very simple sensor. It sits right on your intake piping, and its whole goal is reading airflow to optimize air to fuel ratios. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump into some of the signs and symptoms that you're gonna notice when you have a P0101 engine code. Now, of course, the engine code itself is gonna be the most helpful in pointing you in the direction of what the problem is. But when you have a P0101, because it affects your air to fuel ratios, it is very common to also get a handful of performance related problems such as rough idling, a loss of power, or kind of sluggish hesitations when accelerating, and you'll also see a decrease in your fuel economy. Those are going to be the three kind of primary things that you'll notice when you have issues with your mass airflow sensor. But it also is possible to have black smoke coming out of your exhaust pipe. And that would be the case if your engine is dumping way too much fuel into the engine because it doesn't know how much air is coming in, so it doesn't know how much fuel to send in. And then you can also get a number of other error codes relating to the air to fuel ratios. So you might see something like a P0171 or a P0174 that indicates that your air to fuel ratios are either too rich or too lean. Like I mentioned earlier, usually a P0101 isn't that severe, and so you might notice a little bit of rough idling, but you're probably not going to notice a whole lot of serious performance related issues that are going to affect your drivability, but you likely are going to notice some of these small things that go along with it. So with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about how to diagnose and pinpoint what the problem is so that we can fix the P0101. As I mentioned, this leads directly to the mass airflow sensor, and the mass airflow sensor is located on your intake. So there aren't really a whole lot of things here that could be causing this that isn't related to the intake itself or the mass airflow sensor. And so when it comes to diagnosing and fixing this problem, that's exactly where we're going to want to look. Step one is going to be to locate your mass airflow sensor, which is going to require you to locate your intake and your intake piping. So once you locate it, go ahead and take a look at all of your intake piping and make sure you don't have any cracks in it. There's not any gaps or loose couplers that are causing air leaks, because if you have a lot of air leaking out of the intake system, that could affect your readings as well. Go ahead and inspect all of your intake piping to make sure you don't have any issues there. Step two, I'd recommend removing your mass airflow sensor and cleaning it. The mass airflow sensors, because they sit there and have a ton of air passing through it, they naturally over time can get kind of gunked up and catch a bunch of debris that your air filter doesn't catch. And that's especially true if you have an oiled air filter too. Mass airflow sensors do get dirty, they get gunked up, and your AutoZone or O'Reilly's or local auto parts store actually will have a specific mass airflow sensor cleaner. I'd recommend going and getting a can of mass airflow sensor cleaner and giving it a clean. Also, while you're doing that, I would recommend removing your air filter and cleaning out your air filter or replacing your air filter as well, which if you haven't replaced your air filter in a while, is probably a smart thing to do. So once you've inspected your intake piping, if there's no issues there, you've cleaned the mass airflow sensor and you've cleaned out your air filter, if you're still getting this error code, then you probably just have a faulty mass airflow sensor. A lot of times cleaning it does the trick, making sure your intake is functioning properly will also do the trick, but it is just possible that the mass airflow sensor fails. And if that's the case, if you go through all these steps and you still have this error code, then go ahead and replace your mass airflow sensor, which fortunately most of the time they're not super expensive and they're very easy to just go ahead and DIY. So ultimately it's a pretty easy fix and there's not a whole lot else that goes into this. There are a few other things that could lead to P0101 engine codes. They just aren't super common. I would say 98% of the time you either have a dirty MAF sensor or you just have a faulty one that needs to be replaced. But a couple other things that could cause it are vacuum leaks, issues with other sensors like your throttle position sensor. You could have PCM related issues, and specific to GM vehicles, these codes tend to pop up when you have a clogged catalytic converter. But when you get this code with a clogged catalytic converter, you're probably going to get a bunch of other codes with it. So ultimately, like I mentioned, if you just have a P0101 or you have a P0101 with a P0171 or 174, your issue probably is specific to the mass airflow sensor, as there isn't a whole lot of other things that really could cause this. And in these instances where some other issue is causing this, you're probably going to have a bunch of other error codes coming with it. So that wraps up our video on P0101 engine codes and mass airflow sensors. I hope you guys appreciate this video. If you did, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future content we have coming.